हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर पूजा सिंह, अ BMS डॉक्टर करंटली वर्किंग इन ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट द ट्यूबरक्लोसिस एंड इट्स होलिस्टिक मैनेजमेंट। ट्यूबरक्लोसिस और कंजप्शन इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट ड्रेडेड डिजीजेस। इट इज अ मेजर हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम इन इंडिया एंड ऑफन एंड रेटेड द नंबर वन किलर। Over 5 lakh people die of this disease every year. Tuberculosis is caused by a tiny germ called tubercle bacillus, which is so small that it can be detected only by a microscope. The germ enters into the body through the nose, mouth and windpipe and settles down in the lungs. It multiplies by millions and produces small raised spots called tubercle. The tuberculosis is not a hereditary but an infectious or communicable disease. Those suffering from the disease for a considerable time in the eject living germs while coughing or spitting. And when this enters the nose or mouth of healthy person, they contract the disease. Mouth breathing and kissing as well as contaminated food and water are also responsible for spreading tuberculosis. Symptoms. Tuberculosis is of four types, namely of lungs, intestine, bones and glands. Pulmonary tuberculosis or tuberculosis of the lung is by far the most common type of tuberculosis. It tends to consume the body and the patient loses strength, color and weight. Other symptoms are a raise in temperature, especially in the evening, a persistent cough and hoarseness, difficulty in breathing and pain in the shoulders, indigestion, chest pain and blood in the sputum. Causes. Lower resistance or devitalization of the system is the chief cause of this disease. This condition is brought about mainly by mineral starvation of the tissues of the body due to an inadequate diet, and the chief mineral concerned is calcium. In many ways, therefore, tuberculosis is the disease of calcium deficiency. There can be no breakdown of the tissues and no tuberculosis growth where there is adequate supply of organic calcium in the said tissues. Thus, an adequate supply of organic calcium in the system together with organic mineral matter is a sure preventive of the development of tuberculosis. Lower resistance also results from a variety of other factors such as suppression of the disease by drugs and medication, use of stale, devitaminized and acid-forming foods, eating wrong combination of foods such as taking fruits with starchy foods at one meal, causing fermentation in the stomach, wasting of energy through exercise, loss of semen, and living in ill-ventilated houses. Other causes include exposure to cold, loss of sleep, impure air, a sedentary life, overwork, contaminated milk, use of tobacco in any form, liquor of all kinds, tea, coffee and all harmful drinks. The factors prepare the ground for the growth of germs of various kinds, including tubercle bacillus. These germs may be present in the body but are quite harmless for those who are full of vitality and natural resistance. Treatment. Tuberculosis is no longer considered incurable if it is tackled in early stage. An all-round scheme of dietic and vitality building programs along natural lines is the only method to overcome the disease. As a first step, the patient should be put on an excessive fresh fruit diet for 3 to 4 days. He should have 3 meals a day of fresh juicy fruits such as apples, grapes, pears, peaches, oranges, pineapple, melon or any other juicy fruits in the season. Bananas, dried or tinned fruits should not be taken. For drinks, unsweetened lemon water or plain water, either hot or cold, may be taken. If losing such weights on an all-fruit diet, those already under weight may add a glass of milk to each fruit meal. After the all fruit diet, the patient should adopt a fruit and milk diet. For this diet, the meals are exactly the same as the all fruit diet, but with milk added to each fruit meal. The patient may begin with a liter of milk the first day and increase by quarter liter daily up to the 2 to 2.5 liter, according to how the milk agrees. The milk should be fresh and unboiled, but may be slightly warmed if desired. It should be sipped very slowly. The fruit and milk diet should be continued for 4 to 6 weeks. Thereafter, the following dietary may be adopted. Breakfast: fresh fruit and fresh food as obtainable and milk. Prunes and other dried fruits may also be taken if desired. Lunch: steamed vegetables as available. 1 or 2 whole wheat chapatis and a glass of buttermilk. Dinner: a bowl of raw salads of juices, vegetables, suitable vegetables and whole wheat bread and butter. Stewed fruits or cooked apple may be taken for desserts. At bedtime, a glass of milk. Thank you.